Let's pray. Father God, we want to praise you for your mighty presence in this place, Lord. Father, we know, Lord, that you are going to touch us this evening, Master. Lord, you are going to release us from every kind of fear this evening, Master. Father, as we are going to speak on the subject of divine protection today, Master, Lord, you will teach us something new from your word in the name of Jesus, Master. Lord, no verses as we read, Lord, the devil will not fool us, Master. The devil will not say that I know this verse before I've been reading for the past 20 years, Master. Lord, we will read every verse as if we are reading and receiving for the first time.
Yes.
Fresh manna, yes. We will receive from you today in the name of Jesus. None of us, Lord, will go out of this auditorium unblessed, Master, yes. Untouched, Master, undelivered, Master. Every person will go out of this auditorium completely, thoroughly blessed in the name of Jesus, Master. We thank you, Father, for your word, Lord. Powerful words, your word, Master. Thank you. In Jesus' mighty and matchless and precious name, we ask and say,
Amen.
Amen. So today the topic which we are going to meditate upon is our right to divine protection.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Our right to divine protection. We all know that we are living in a world where there is complete darkness, where there is destruction, where there is uncertainties, where there are threats, where there are dangers. A lot of things are there in the world. This is the time that every Christian, that is you and me, should know to appropriate our blood-bought right to divine protection. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. As a matter of fact, the desperate need for security and protection is universal. It is not only for Christians. Every creation, every mankind need protection. Amen? But we Christians, I want to tell you, we Christians have a special right to divine protection.
Yes.
We are going to see that today through scriptures. Amen? Because we know whom we serve. We know who is our Savior. The world does not know the Savior, but you and me know who is our Savior. That is the divine protection we are going to talk about today. Amen? This message is for all the age groups.
Yes.
Even little angels, you can concentrate and you can learn the word of God today. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah. The objective of today's message is to destroy every spirit of fear from our lives today.
Yes.
Amen? If you and me are born again, remember that from the time we were born again, God assigned angels to escort us from this evil world. If you agree with me,
yes,
you can say amen.
Yes.
Amen? There is no need for you or me to fear because our lives are already covered by the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
Amen? And you see what Psalms 103 verse 4 says, who redeems your life from destruction?
Yes.
Who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies? This scripture confirms you and me that he has already redeemed you and me from every destruction. Can somebody say that I am redeemed from destruction? Amen? So divine protection means to be defeated from trouble, to defended from every harm, every danger, every power of darkness, every criticism. And Bible says God will fight for you and me.
Amen.
If you agree with me,
yes,
say amen. God will fight your battles and he will shield you from the attacks of every enemy in our life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As we together meditate on his word today, our right to divine protection, I pray that we will be forever set free from every fear in our lives. We will be set free from every fear of abandonment. We will be set free from every fear of rejection. We will be set free from every fear of threats. We will be set free from every fear of loss. We will be set free from every fear of lack. We will be set free from every fear of tomorrow. We will be set free from everything was a Satan is putting fear in our lives for. Amen?
Yes.
All the fear that you and I may have today it says, where is the man who fears the Lord? God will teach him how to choose the best. He shall live there within God's circles of blessing, and his children shall inhabit the earth. Friendship with God is reserved for those who reverence him. With them alone, he shares the secret of his promises. Hallelujah. Scripture teaches us that for the man who fears the Lord, there is a place prepared for him called God's circle of blessing. Amen. You can say, I live within God's circle of blessing today. Amen. When we choose to revere God and become his friend, he will reveal all his secrets to you and me. And these secrets will take us into God's circles of blessing and erase every fear from our hearts. This word secret in this verse makes me understand that even though we have written Bible in our hands to understand everything, but there is still something which God wants to reveal to each and every one personally. To know that secret, we need to be in his secret chamber. Amen? In the hiding places of the Most High God.
Yes.
NKJV of Psalm 25:14 says, the secret of the Lord is with those who fear him, and he will show them his covenant. Amen? We have hold a new covenant. Then which covenant, I asked God, you are talking about? And I was wondering. Then the Holy Spirit was explaining to me that when I in the tabernacle, when I dwell in the secret chamber of the Most High God, I will get complete understanding of God and his word.
Yes.
Amen. Once we are in that chamber, we will fear nothing. No fear can befall you or me.
Amen.
Amen. That is the divine protection of God, which is available only for you and me, Christians. Amen. If you remember Psalm 91:1, where Moses also brings us to realization that there is a secret place of the Most High God. And NKJV gives the heading, safety of abiding in the presence of God. Amen. He who dwells in the secret places of the Most High shall abide there under the shadow of the Almighty. The secret place of the Most High God is what David is talking about in the previous scripture, Psalms 25, and he says, God's circle of blessing. Amen. When we are hidden in those secret places, we will have no fear except the fear of God. Meaning, in the secret places, we will be only reverencing God and forget about all our fears. So this is our divine protection. As we read further in Psalm 91 verses 7 and 8, it says, particularly in Amplified Version, it says, 1,000 may fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but no danger will come near you. Can you say now, amen for God? Amen. That danger will not come when we are hidden in that secret chamber of the Most High God. Amen. Verse 8 says, you will only be a spectator as you look on with your eyes and witness what divine repayment of the wicked as you watch safely from the shelter of the Most High.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I love these verses. It really blesses our hearts to know.
Yes.
Because as long as you and me are living in that secret place of the Most High God, we are inaccessible to every strategy of Satan.
Yes.
Amen. And people of the world do not have this privilege of dwelling in the secret places. Why? Because they know not our God and the divine protection that he has blessed you and me with.
Amen.
That is why I have given the name of the topic, our right to the divine protection.
Amen.
Amen. Only you and me, blessed, washed the children of God, has the right to divine protection.
Yes. Yes.
That's what we are learning these days in LCU. Amen. Morning Zoom also talked about that book. We are learning true worship these days in LCU, and I really appreciate if everyone can get hold of that book and read, and you will be thoroughly blessed. And in that, what we are learning, only true worshippers have the privilege to dwell in secret places.
Amen.
True worshippers or who? Those who intimately commune with God on regular basis.
Yes, yes.
Amen. As yes. we read in Psalm 25, Psalmist says, when we are in the circle of God's blessings, we will know the secrets of God.
Yes.
Circles of God's blessing is available only in the hiding place. Amen. Secret chamber of God. Let me give you a little glimpse of what true worship is all about, which we are learning in LCU. True worship is not about all those fast songs and slow songs. That is what the author of that book is teaching us, and it really blesses us. He is saying that this is not about a slow song or a fast song that is worship. True worship is not what we call as a corporate worship. Worship is not an event. Worship is not a musical term. Rather, true worship is a passionate pursuit of the presence of the Most High God.
Yes.
Amen. That is what we are learning. True worship is mutual between you and God, between me and God. Amen. That is true worship. Hence, a revelation of true worship is essential to the life of every believer. It is intimate fellowship, intimate communion with God Most High in a secret chamber. One-on-one communion with the Most High without getting distracted of anything in life is true worship.
Amen.
Last week I gave them the example that if somebody is glued to TV, if watching some program in the TV, they are completely glued to that place. And when you walk or pass by them also, they may not know that somebody has walked like that kind of glue, that kind of single-mindedness God is expecting from you and me in true worship. Amen. Even when, I think Lucy also put in the WhatsApp that when her husband is watching the matches, football matches, he's so glued, even if you go and take water from the fridge or make some noise, he will not know. Amen. I was telling the students that that is true worship. Our focus on the Most High God with single-mindedness, then no fear can befall you and me. That is our rightful divine protection.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So people of this world cannot even understand or rest because they fear the things of the world which are taking place these days in earth. Amen. Whereas you and me are covenant people of God. Say, I am covenant people. Amen. We will be resting place. We will be resting in the secret place of the Most High God. As and when you want, you can enter into the secret chamber. I understand that God has accepted the full responsibility for providing divine protection to His children, that is you and me. Amen. There is a place mentioned in Psalm 91:1 where none of God's foe can penetrate into. That is the secret chamber. That is the divine protection. That is our legal right as a child of God to enter into that divine protection. Apostle Paul also confirms this powerful truth in Colossians 3:3 when he said, for you died to this world and your new life, or your real life is hidden there with Christ in God. The word hidden means secret place, a place of security, a place of protection. So our security, our protection lies only in Jesus Christ, in God. But if we are not dead to this world, then the place of security is not available to you and me. We must remember that we must die to this world. Amen. The place of security is available to only those when we die to this world. Amen. Before the evil can get to you, we will have to first of all penetrate the defenses of God. It is like this. I'm standing here and somebody is standing before me. That is Jesus Christ. You cannot see me. The enemy cannot see me because the enemy has to cross Jesus Christ to touch me. I am hidden in Christ.
Yes.
That is what is the layman language understanding of this me.
Yes.
Amen. That is our divine protection.
Yes.
Amen. Whether you and I know this point or not, enemy knows it very well that our divine protection is Jesus Christ Himself.
Amen.
Amen. I will show you scripturally when we go through this message. You just stay with me. Amen.
Yes.
You and I should always dwell in the secret places of the Most High, in the very circle of God's blessing, which is our foremost right as a child of God for divine protection. We must remember and understand that God has made His divine protection available to you and me and our families in every dark days. We all know things in the world will get much worse in the coming days to come than it was really before. Isaiah 60 verse 2, talking about the end times, declares, "For in fact, darkness will cover the earth and deep darkness will cover the people, but the Lord will do what? Will rise upon you and me, Jerusalem, and His glory and brilliance will be seen there on you and me." Amen. I like what Barnes wrote, B-A-R-N-E-S. The methods of Bible study, we understood and learned how to read the commentaries, notes, everything. So one of the Barnes wrote for the scripture, he writes like this: "Darkness shall envelop the whole world except where it is illuminated by the gospel." This, for this verse, he has written this commentary: "Darkness shall envelop the whole world except where it is illuminated by the gospel." So it is needless to say that this was the fact Messiah came, and that is still extensively true today also for you and me and for the people yet to come in the Lord.
Amen.
And if darkness is upon the earth, Lord will rise upon you, Jerusalem, and His glory and brilliance will be seen on you. So we have nothing to fear. Say, I have nothing to fear.
I have nothing to fear.
Rather, let us learn to enjoy our right to divine protection. When talking about the signs and the ends of the age, Jesus also spoke in Luke 21 verse 26. New Living Translation says, "People will be terrified at what they see coming upon the earth, for the powers in the heavens will be shaken."
Yes.
Notice that this world is on a crashing course with a program called darkness. Not only we Christians, even the heathens knows and understands that we are living in dark days. It is in the midst of this turmoil, God's covenant protection has been made available to you and me Christians. Amen. Can we give a clap offering to Jesus for this divine protection? In the midst of darkness, in the midst of turmoil, He has made this divine protection available for you and me. God wants to demonstrate that even though we are living in this world, we are not of this world. Amen. Therefore, it may be dark in Egypt, but it shall always be light in Goshen.
Yes.
Amen. God's glory or His manifested goodness shall be seen in our lives as we begin to realize that regardless of what devil unleashes against humanity, we are still inaccessible to the strategies of evil.
Yes.
Amen. In studying this subject, I also began to realize that the scriptures have many descriptions of God with regard to our protection. And I'm not going to read all those scriptures. Next two slides, if you want, you can take a snapshot and read at your convenience. There are scriptures talking about this. Exodus 14:14, 23:27, 2 Samuel 5:24, 2 Chronicles 20:29. All these describe God as a man of war. He's the one who fights your battles. And next few scriptures, all these scriptures describe God as our defense. He is the impenetrable edge of protection. And further scriptures describe God as our fortress. He is the stronghold of our lives.
Yes.
And further scripture describe God as our hiding place, and He is our shelter in times of trouble.
Yes.
And further scripture describes God as our refuge. He is our heaven, safe heaven and retreat. And further scripture describes God as our shield, and He will never leave us exposed to the attacks of the wicked one without making provisions for the way out. seriously to those who refuse to be intimidated in any way. Apostle Paul wrote in Philippians 1:28, again amplified version, and in no way be alarmed or intimidated in anything by your opponents, for such constancy and fearlessness on your part is a clear sign, a proof and a seal for them of their impending destruction, but a clear sign for you of your deliverance and salvation, and that too from God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we will not be afraid of those who are against us. All of this proof from God's word that you and me are being saved and enemy has lost its battle. Amen. When you are bold, the enemy is weak. And the opposite is also true. When I am weak, the enemy is stronger. When I operate in my right to access the divine protection, I will flee from every fear.
Amen.
Amen. Opposite is also true. When I operate in fear, I don't access to my rightful place of divine protection.
Yes.
Amen. If you refuse to be terrified by the enemies, it affects their confidence.
Yes.
You all know that in any battle, the one who gives to fear first is the one who will lose the battle.
Yes.
Amen. So let us understand today, our God is a strong refuge for us. Let us not lose the battle by giving way to any fear in our lives. Amen. Psalm 118 verse 6 says, the Lord is for me, so I have no fear. Who can, what have mere people do to me?
Amen.
When the Lord is for you, why should you and me fear? Amen. It is time to press on towards our God-given destiny. When God speaks, our confidence will be greatly tested. Many people may not support our decisions. As our brothers are sitting here from Hindu background, as I testified to them that I'm also coming from Hindu background. I mean, there are many people who don't stand with us today. You all know that none of our families are yet saved or born again. There are many people who don't stand with us. But God's promise is present in Exodus 23 verse 20. He says, see, I am sending an angel before you to protect you on your journey and lead you safely to the place I have prepared for you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Big journey God is talking about, our life journey here on earth. I take every scripture when I read, I pray over them as if it is for today and it is for tomorrow. Every scripture when I read, I like to apply it upon me and my families, upon church, upon workplace, and I read it as if it is my mind today and for my tomorrow. Amen. So this scripture is for you and me for today and tomorrow. God would not only protect and defend us, but he would also lead us to live in a place which he has already prepared for you and me.
Yes.
He is a God. He has already set before us an open door which no man can shut. If you all know that scripture that say amen.
Amen.
Our right to divine protection door is open for us and also to anyone who accept Jesus Christ as their personal savior.
Yes.
Amen. All our questions will cease when we enter into God's presence, the place prepared for us by God, that is his secret chamber. It is no other place he's talking about. He's talking about those secret chambers where he is waiting for you and me to commune with him every day of our lives. Amen. When we are under the shadow of the Almighty, our safety and our victory is guaranteed. If you agree with me, say amen. Our hearts will begin to enjoy, filled with joy when it is awakened to all these kinds of truth. Amen. Whenever I read scriptures like this, I really get excited. I really get excited that when I'm dwelling in those secret places, everything around me is only peace. Everything around me is only joy. And no fear can befall me of any man, of any kind, in the name of Jesus. Amen. I pray that our eyes will be opened so that we can see the multitudes of angels as mentioned in Psalm 91 that are surrounding our lives and our households. Amen. Psalm 34:7 also confirms that his angels guard those who honor the Lord and rescues them from what? Danger. Amen. If we choose God. Regardless of what is happening around you and me, as I told you, we have the blood-bought right to say, secure in the divine protection, in the God circle of blessing. His angels have charge over us to keep us in all our ways. As mentioned in Psalm 91:11, God will put his angels in charge of you. Yes. To do what? To protect you wherever you go. Yes. Hallelujah. Divine protection is available to you and me wherever we go. Promise to Belen. There is yet another promise of God which is there in Zechariah chapter 2 verse 5. I'm sure you all know the scripture. The Lord has promised that he himself will be what? A wall of fire around the city to protect it, and that he will live there in all his glory. What does you and me want more than this? Who is there our God like unto him? Amen. Our God, he himself will be a wall of fire around you, your families, and everything that concerns you and me. Amen. What a shadow to live under. There can be no beautiful hiding place than this. If you agree with me, say amen. Hallelujah. We will always be living in the circle of God's blessings. Let us not be ignorant of our covenant rights to divine protection. Yes. Ephesians 2, 12 and 13 says, once you were apart from Christ, you were foreigners, and you did not belong to God's chosen people. You were no part in the covenants which were based on God's promises to his people. But now, before you were living in the world without hope and without God, but now in union with Jesus Christ, you who used to be far away have been brought near the blood of Jesus Christ. That is the divine protection. Before we were living without divine protection, when the blood of Jesus was shed for you and me, we are already covered under the divine protection. Amen. If you are a stranger to your covenant, your right to divine protection, you will have no hope of God in the world you are living. That is what the scripture says. If anyone in our midst or watching this video who are not yet born again, who doesn't know what is this covenant we are talking about in this place, you have been chosen by God today. As you hear this message, God is calling you. The blood of Jesus is calling you, and you can also come under the shadow of this divine blessing in the name of Jesus. Amen. In the same way, we all know that Hosea also spoke, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge.
Yes.
Because why? Because you have rejected knowledge, I will also reject you.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Today, as the Holy Spirit gave us this message, let us remember once again what is the protection for us in Christ Jesus. Not be lacking of knowledge of our covenant rights. I pray that we will begin to develop faith in the promises of God as we discover our rights to divine protection. If you remember, I told you to stay with me to know how devil knows God has put an edge of protection over our lives. I'm going to tell you now. Job was a classic example, classic case of someone who was ignorant of his covenant of divine protection. Job chapter 1 verses 8 to 10 says, did you notice my servant Job? The Lord asked. You can put your name also. Did you notice my servant Padma? The Lord asked. There is no one on earth as faithful and good as she is. She worships me and is careful not to do anything evil. See what the Satan says in the next verse. Satan replied, would Padma worship you if she got nothing out of it? You have always protected her, her family, and everything that she owns. You bless everything she does, and you have given her enough cattle to fill the whole country. So in this scripture, we find very interesting conversation taking place between God and Satan. God was bragging about Padma to Satan, and God told Satan there was none like Padma in the whole of earth. And God said that Padma was a perfect and upright woman that feared God and shunned evil. In response to all this, Satan says, does Padma fear God for nothing? In essence, Satan was saying to God, you are right in all that you have said about Padma, but that is a reason for it. God, have you not put an edge around Padma and her household what devil knows about the edge of protection that is available for you and me, God's people. We may not be, we may be ignorant about the edge of protection many a times, but devil always knows, devil never forgets that edge of protection around you and me. Amen? Devil also knew about this, but our brother Job was ignorant of his covenant protection and thus lived in fear of sudden destruction. We can see that in Job chapter 3 verse 25 and 26. He says, everything I fear and dread that comes true. I have no peace, no rest, and my troubles never end. Amen. Job's ignorance of his covenant rights caused him to operate in fear, and that fear connected him to the very thing that he was afraid of.
Yes.
So the same thing is true for you and me today. Mm-hmm. Amen. We can learn from Job today and not to fear that very thing so that it come to pass. Amen. Rather, we can choose to adopt the covenant rights available to us in Christ Jesus. Amen. The tragedy was he opened the door to fear. Amen. Let us not spend our days in fear. Our God is a man of war.
Amen.
He is a defense. He is a fortress. He is a hiding place. He is a refuge. He is a shield. He is a buckler. He is a strong tower. He is calling each and every one of us today to hide in those secret places that he has prepared for us in a secret chamber. Let us believe that he has put a hedge around you and me. He has put a hedge around your family and my family.
Yes.
He has put a hedge around all your possessions and my possessions. He is a wall of fire around us. Satan cannot penetrate to our arena without touching that edge of protection, without that wall of fire. Amen. Let us make Psalm 27 verses 1 to 3 the theme of our life today. The Lord is my light. You can also say, the Lord is my light and my salvation. I will fear no one. The Lord protects me from all danger. I will never be afraid. When evil people attack me and try to kill me, they stumble and fall. Even if a whole army surrounds me, I will not be afraid. Even if enemies attack me, I will still trust God. Can you give a clap of hands? It's time for God's people to live our lives with an unshakable confidence.
Yes.
Because we live in God's circle of blessings.
Yes.
That is a secret place for us that ungodly don't know about. Amen. Whatever is our fear today, let us take authority over it. As I'm going to close this message, because every wall of fear will have to be demolished today in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
We must recognize that our fear is a spirit.
Yes.
Satan is using to torment that spirit for fear and to control and to dominate and to oppress you and me and to bind the people, including born again Christians like you and me. Satan's only objective is to build a wall of fear in our minds. To do what? To immoralize our faith in Christ Jesus. To stop us from taking possession of our covenant rights. To cause us to disobey God. To stop us from doing the works of God. To stop us from operating in the gifts of the Holy Spirit. But today I'm here to remind you and me that we have our right to divine protection. To overcome every fear. As we dwell in that secret place, there is divine stability and constancy to the word of every word of God. Amen. His word, his promises never fluctuate, sir. Amen. His promises are made in Christ, who purchased them with his own precious blood. By his death, Christ made effective the covenant which contains all the promises of God. So let us keep our vision alive. Let us keep our vision of salvation of our loved ones alive in the name of Jesus, sir. Let us not be dry and go into any kind of fear which the devil is bringing. Let us keep our vision alive. Let us keep our vision alive for our ministry in the name of Jesus. Amen. Now Keshni and team are going to sing us a song which we are going to offer unto God. Amen. The song is from the book of Psalms 32 verse 7. And it says like this, Lord, you are my hiding place.
Yes.
You always fill my heart with songs of deliverance.
Yes.
whenever I am afraid, Lord, I will trust in you.
Yes.
This is the psalm that we are going to sing for you and me, as we are all going to stand upon our feet and we are going to concentrate on those secret chamber which I'm talking about in this place. Let's all stand and commune with God. Amen. Remember, we are under the care of such a God who says, you call me in the day of trouble and I will deliver you. We are worshipping a God like this. We have a God who says, I will never leave you, neither forsake you.
Yes.
He is a God who said to Moses and also to you and me today, do not be afraid, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord God Almighty. For the Egyptians that you see them today, you will see them no more. And I want to convert this verse to fear. The fear which you and me see today, we will see them no more in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let us come out of every fear today. As they minister the song unto God, Shikavaranda Shaka. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Shikavaranda Shaka. Let's come out of every fear of lack, every fear of life, every fear of death, every fear of losing the job, every fear of job loss, every fear of sickness, every fear of harm and danger, because He is there to protect us.
Yes.
Always there. We read so many scriptures today. Let us choose to live in the circle of God's blessings. Let us choose to live in those secret chambers of the Most High God and commune with Him. Let us not get distracted from the evil forces, whatever is bringing. Let us not concentrate today. Let us choose to concentrate on our rights to divine protection.
Thank you. saying the word is one thing and believing it is another and saying it is another and confessing it is another and accepting it into our spirit is another thing altogether. So I want to say, will you please just put up E in Psalm 91. We're going to confess it over our own lives. Okay, we're going to speak it over our own lives in faith. We're going to put it with our own names there. Okay? We're going to speak it out aloud. Because speaking it aloud makes our spirits believe what we have just heard. If you please open your Bibles with me to Psalm 91. Doesn't matter what version you have. Because we're going to confess His word. Irrespective of the version that will come to pass. Tell me when you're ready. Are you ready? If you can just put it out there as well, if someone doesn't have their Bible open. Okay, this is how we're going to say it. You're not going to say, He who dwelleth. You're going to say, because I dwell in the secret place of the Most High, I will abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust. Surely He will deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He will cover me with His feathers, and under His wings will I trust. His truth will be my shield and my buckler. I will not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that wastes at noonday. I know 1,000 will fall at my side and 10,000 at my right hand, but it shall not come near me. Only with my eyes shall I see and behold the Lord of the wicked. Because I have made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, my habitation. No evil befall me, neither shall any plague come near my dwelling or the dwelling of my family.
Father, we are so grateful,
yes, Lord.
Amen. Surely you are a hiding place.
Yes, Lord.
There is no other place to hide.
Yes.
There is no other shelter that can protect us.
Yes.
Oh Lord, but your hedge of your fire is all around us.
Yes,
that you preserve us, you protect us.
Yes.
Lord, protection is our birthright.
Yes.
Amen.
Preservation is our birthright.
Amen.
Safety is our birthright.
Yes.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
And we are grateful to you tonight. And Lord, we will enjoy it all the days of our lives because we dwell in the secret place of the Most High God. Oh Father, we want to say thank you in the Holy of Holies.
Thank you,
and
Jesus.
We bless your name. And Lord, more than that, you have come to live in us.
Yes.
And because you live in us, oh Father God, your holy angels, they protect God's anointing in our lives. And Father, we are grateful to you. We are thankful to you. Lord, I pray that Father, the work of our hands will be blessed. Lord, I pray that our lives will be blessed, our marriages will be blessed, our jobs and our finances will be blessed, our businesses will be blessed, your church will thrive, will flourish, and will prosper.
Yes.
And Christ will be alone glorified.
Yes.
Lord, I thank you. I lift up your servant into your hand as she brought forth, oh Lord, this word of encouragement to us. Oh Lord, for us to know and understand that we are divinely protected by God forever and ever and ever. I pray that you will reward her. You will bless her. Oh Father, she will see her whole family saved. Oh Father, worshipping Yeshua the Messiah. Oh Lord, serving the name of Jesus, the Son of the Most High God. That's what we pray, O God. Be with her, O God. Keep her from every appearance of evil, O God. And Lord, I pray that she'll continue to grow in the knowledge of your will and understanding. And your anointing will continue to multiply in her life and will flow to the nations, that God will be alone glorified. We want to say thank you, Lord. Lord, I pray that there will be no spirit of fear that will operate in any one of our lives. When we sleep, we will sleep soundly, O God. O Father, we will sleep in peace, O Father. O Lord, because your word says that you grant sleep to your beloved. And Father, I pray there will be no nightmares. If anyone suffers with nightmares, I come against it in the name of Jesus. Every demonic spirit of fear that brings horror, that brings trouble, that brings fear in the minds of God's people, I bind you and I command you to come out in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I set your people free in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, your people will be fearless people, full of faith, full of honor, full of power, full of boldness, and full of courage of the Holy Ghost. And you will receive the preeminence of the glory. We thank you, we bless you. As we depart to God, we know that your holy presence goes with us wherever we go. And Father, we thank you for that. We give you the praise, glory, honor, and dominion. And let your name be alone lifted high. In Jesus' most holy, mighty, and matchless name we pray. Amen. Amen. Now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father, and the fellowship of his sweet Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. And all of us said, Amen. 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 Give the Lord a big clap. God bless you. God be with you. And we'll see you again the following Friday. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.